بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. اللهم ربنا تقبل طاعتنا واجعلنا برحمتك من عتقائك من النيران في هذا الشهر الكريم. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all our worship and make us among those who've been freed from the doom of the hellfire in this blessed month. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alamin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah, toward the end of Surah An-Nisa, قَالَ بَعْدَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ بُرْهَانٌ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَأَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكُمْ نُورًا مُّبِينًا. O mankind, is great evidence that came to you from your Lord, and we have sent down to you a Noor, light, mubeen, clear. Which is mean, imagine a light which is clear, so no one in any way can miss this light. That's why, you know, it's very obvious the truth, and it is obvious to the point that people cannot see it. And one of the great parable of that, no one will be admiring any landscape without the light, right? But when someone is consumed and really in the admiration of the landscape, he does not figure that without the light he cannot see anything. And at the time of death, when death comes, that part that most of the people have neglected, that what subhanallah will be manifest and obvious. That's why he said, قَالَ رَبِّ ارْجِعُونَ. Oh Allah, take me back. This light that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down is the Qur'an. Therefore, Allah made easy the Qur'an for the remembrance, and we are in the month of the Qur'an. And you can see, just to take serious the very basic thing of the Qur'an, the very basic thing, your Lord is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The very basic thing, your Lord Allah has power over all things. The very basic thing, your Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to whom belong death, to whom belong life, to him belong resurrection. No one else has any control of that. Therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the next ayah, قَالَ فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ. Look, subhanAllah, how honorable, how great is the gift of Allah upon you to be a believer. فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ. As for those who believe in Allah, وَاعْتَصَمُوا. The i'tisam. The i'tisam is to hold fast to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. See, the i'tisam is like you holding, imagine there is a rope, yeah? And someone is on a high rise and almost to fall, and he's going to hold on the rope, yeah, to save himself from falling. How this person is going to hold on this rope? That's how we need to hold fast to the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And holding to Allah and holding fast to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is actually explained in some of the ayat of Surah Al-Ma'idah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala were addressing to Bani Israel, the children of Israel, qala wa qala Allahu inni ma'akum, said Allah, I am be with you if you establish prayer, if you pay zakat, if you believe in my Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, wa azzartumuhu, and you go to support him and help him, not just to follow him. Your implementation of the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and reviving of the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a way of supporting and helping the way of the Prophet to convey his message to next generation and next generation to the end of time. Azzartumu, not just follow him, azzartumu. Wa aqradtumu Allah qardan hasanan, and you loan to Allah. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the all rich, the all powerful, the almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala, he'll accept from you to give him a loan. And this loan is like you give to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow upon you, from wealth, from time, from skills, and you give it for the sake of Allah. وَأَقْرَضُ اللَّهَ قَرْضًا حَسَنًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will expiate all your sins and forgive you and admit you in His rahmah. So when you go back to the ayah of Surah An-Nisa, قَالَ وَاعْتَصَمُ بِهِ. Look, the grant that Allah is going to give you. فَسَيُدْخِلُهُمْ فِي رَحْمَةٍ مِّنْهِ. He's going to admit them and help them to enter in His mercy. You remember yesterday we talked about the vessel that you need as means of transportation into your journey of life. فَيُدْخِلُهُمْ فِي رَحْمَةٍ مِّنْهِ. وَفَضْلٍ. So the fadl is like the infinite khayr from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the infinite goodness. You are already inside it. فَيُدْخِلُهُمْ. It's like a realm of rahmah. Is like sphere of rahmah and sphere of fadl, you're going to be inside it. وَيَهْدِيهِمْ إِلَيْهِ. And He'll guide them to Him on the right path. This is how, subhanAllah, noble and honorable is the believer when he accepts the nur of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the light of Allah, which is the book. And when you have i'tisam billah, nothing, subhanAllah, can stand against you if you are a true believer. In a hadith, in a khabar, قَالَ بِعِزَّةِ وَجَلَالِي مَعْتَصَمَ بِي عَبْدِي وَكَادَتْ لَهُ السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ إِلَّا جَعَلْتُ لَهُ مِنْ بَيْنِهِنَّ مَخْرَجًا. Said, by the tremendous and the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when my servant hold fast to me, and the whole heaven and earth come against him or against her. They plot, all of them, on one word, unanimous word, that they go to hurt you. And you are holding fast to Allah. Allah will make a way out from the heaven and the earth to save you. Remember Musa alayhi salam, running away from the people of Pharaoh because they want to kill him. And he came to Midian and he said, Ya Allah, stranger, starving, and I don't have anything. قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي لِمَا أَنزَلْتَ إِلَيَّ مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَقِيرٍ. Look, subhanAllah, the nature of the believer, they do the good, they hasten to the good. He saw something abnormal. He saw women who not, you know, nobody is helping them. He said, what happened to you? He said, our father is very old and we are waiting till everyone will finish. So he took and he water for them, give them the water. And he didn't ask for help. He didn't ask for food. He didn't ask anything. That's the nobility and the pride of the believer, because he's mu'tasim billah. But after he did everything, he said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in humility, إِنِّي بِمَا أَنزَلْتَ إِلَيَّ مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَقِيرٍ. Ya Allah, whatever you sent to me from good, I'm so poor and in need to it. As soon as he finished, while he is standing or like leaning on a tree, his future wife came to him. I mean, subhanAllah, future wife. She came to invite him. And he got with the righteous man. And he was, subhanAllah, he has the food, and he has the family, and he has the shelter, and he has the fortress, and he was in the preparation. Allah preparing him for a great, subhanAllah, meeting and encounter that is going to be in a tour. This is our life. This is our life. However, there is something, there is, subhanAllah, a dynamics into our relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you do not hold fast to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what is going to happen? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then will not will subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide your heart. So the people of the book, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قال, when they change, when they went against the light of Allah, when they were like altering the ahkam, you know, people that say, oh, you know, this is too much, why should we do this? This is too extreme. You know, there is a lot of things in you we have to modernize and put some modernity in our Quran. And subhanAllah, people, they want a lifestyle to really fit their whims, not a lifestyle where they submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling you that these people, Allah make their heart hard. In the other ayah, قَالَ أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ لَمْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ أَن يُطَهِرَ قُلُوبَهُ. This is the biggest threat for a believer to hear this. Those who Allah refused to cleanse their heart. Can you imagine? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His will to not cleanse the heart of these people. Why? Because they turn away from Allah. They think that they can control their life because they have a good job, because they feel like healthy now, because they feel like, you know, having the science and the technology and everything, that, you know, they can say yes for everything. When we are the poorest and we are the weakest, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calling you, Wallahu yuridu an yatuba alaykum. Brother and sister, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, and Allah want to accept your repentance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to guide you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to be with you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to admit you in His mercy. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam telling us, the one who's not going to be forgiven in Ramadan, he's a person who's deprived. Therefore, let's think to ourselves and say to yourself, Salfim, I'm not going to do an effort in this Ramadan, in all the perspective, in all the perspective. There's a great project, by the way, in the masjid, we call it an Ansar project. They're going to have, mashallah, you know, you can find the information outside. Just you make something between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even $1 a month, like Zinul Habideen, just something that you're going to have a connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just come to your salah more, subhanAllah, with eagerness. Make your siyam, be mindful. When you're breaking the fast, don't only think about the dates that you're going to eat. Think of the dua before the dates. That, Ya Allah, I make this siyam for you, Ya Allah. I'm going to break my fast with your rizq, with the rizq, the provision that you gave me, this tamra, this date that you, Ya Allah, created, and you enabled me to eat it and to chew it and to then absorb it, and it's going to go to my body and give that energy. It's you, Ya Allah. Where is the dua? Therefore, when we're saying subhanAllah in this month, we have, as a believer, who willing, inshallah, to cleanse themselves, to purify their hearts, to be in the path of humility, in the path of begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us, because Allah want to shower you with His mercy. Therefore, do not deprive yourself from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our sins, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to instill in us eagerness to flee to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to help us understand more the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa ila salati arhamukumullah.